Hello, welcome to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I'm at the Bard's College in Solitude. Today we're going to be reading Kolb and the Dragon, which I found in Yorvaskar. Just a small note about this book. It's a choose-your-own-adventure book. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read this book straight through, and I'm going to provide links to skip within the video to the certain passage that you wish to jump to next. But I think it'll be all clear once you see it. I advise you not to listen to this book all the way through. If you're on a mobile device, you might be out of luck. Anyway, there'll be annotations to link to the different pages based on what you choose. Kolb and the Dragon, an adventure for Nord boys. I don't see not why girls can't enjoy it also, though. Kolb was a brave Nord warrior. One day his chief asked Kolb to slay an evil dragon that threatened their village. "Go through the mountain pass, Kolb," his chief said. "You will find the dragon on the other side." Turn to page 2. Kolb took his favorite axe and shield and walked to the pass, where he found a cold cave, a windy cave, and a narrow trail. He'll click the appropriate annotation to either enter the cold cave, enter the windy cave, or walk up the trail. Kolb stepped onto a rocky hill. He could see the dragon sleeping below and a tavern off a road nearby. Click one of the annotations for a climb down or visit tavern. Following the stench, Kolb found a filthy orc. The orc snarled and charged Kolb with his spiked club. Click either raise shield or swing axe. Treading through the marsh, Kolb discovered a wailing ghost blocking his way. Click attack ghost or give gold. The head of the axe lodged itself in the tough, scaly neck of the beast. It wailed and thrashed, but Kolb held on and eventually sawed through the neck, killing the beast. Kolb returned home victorious, and his village was never bothered by the dragon again. The end. Leaving the marsh behind him, Kolb could see the dragon's lair nearby, as well as a small welcoming tavern. Click go to the lair or go to tavern. A strong gust of wind blew Kolb's torch out and knocked him into a pit, where he split his head and died. The end. The orc cackled as his club splintered Kolb's shield and smashed into his face. There Kolb died, and the orc had soup from his bones. The end. Kolb remembered a story his grand told him and tossed 2 gold chits for the ghost, and it faded away, allowing him to pass. Click to turn to page 7. Kolb crept towards the belly of the beast, but no sooner had he taken his eyes off the head of the beast than it snapped him up and ate him whole, axe and all. The end. Climbing up, Kolb found a camp. He met a wise man who shared bread and showed 2 paths to the dragon's lair. One went through the hills, the other through a marsh. Click the annotation for take the hills or take the marsh. Before the orc could strike, Kolb swung his mighty axe. The orc's head and club fell uselessly to the floor. Click the annotation to turn to page 3. Kolb stopped at a tavern to rest before fighting the dragon. High elves ran the tavern, however, and poisoned his mead so they could steal his gold. The end. Kolb swung his axe as hard as he could, but the ghost hardly seemed to notice. The ghost drifted into Kolb, and a deep sleep took him over, from which he never awoke. The end. Kolb found the lair where the dragon slept, tendrils of smoke wafting from its nostrils. The air made Kolb's eyes sting, and he nearly slipped on the bones of men, picked clean. The beast lay on its side, the throat and belly both waiting targets. Click one of the annotations to strike the neck or strike the belly. Kolb stepped into the frozen cave, but his Nord blood kept him warm. A smelly tunnel climbed ahead of him, and wind howled from another to his left. A ladder was nearby as well. Click the appropriate annotation to take the smelly tunnel, take the windy tunnel, or climb the ladder. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim, Kolb, and the Dragon.